Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Wednesday of the 25th week in Ordinary Time and the Feast of Saint Padre Pio. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Your priests, O Lord, shall be clothed with justice. Your holy ones shall ring out their joy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who by the singular grace gave the priest Saint Pius a share in the cross of your Son, and by means of his ministry, renew the wonders of your mercy, grant that through his intercession, we may be united constantly to the sufferings of Christ, and so brought happily to the glory of the resurrection. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
First reading. A reading from the book of Proverbs. Every word of God is tested. He is a shield to those who take refuge in him. Add nothing to his words, lest he reprove you, and you will be exposed as a deceiver. Two things I ask of you. Deny them, not to me before I die. Put falsehood and lying far from me. Give me neither poverty nor riches. Provide me only with the food I need, lest being full I deny you, saying, Who is the Lord? Or being in want I steal and profane the name of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
Remove from me the way of your falsehood, and favor me with your law.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
The law of your mouth is to me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
Your word, O Lord, endures forever. It is firm as the heavens.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
From every evil way I withhold my feet, that I may keep your words.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
Through your precepts I gain discernment, therefore I hate every false way.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet.
Falsehood I hate and abhor, your law I love.
Your word, O Lord, is a lamp for my feet. Alleluia, alleluia. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus summoned the 12 and gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases. And he sent them to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. He said to them, Take nothing for the journey, neither walking stick, nor sack, nor food, nor money, and let no one take a second tunic. Whatever house you enter, stay there and leave from there. And as for those who do not welcome you, when you leave that town, shake the dust from your feet in testimony against them. They set out and went from village to village, proclaiming the good news and curing diseases everywhere. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we celebrate the feast of Saint Padre Pio, Saint Pius, no? And probably one of the big devotions in the Catholic Church. Most certainly here, a very big devotion here in the Philippines. You have the national shrine in Batangas, and then you have, prior to the national shrine, you have that little center in on Libis, near beside Eastwood, which really is visited by so many people. And before the pandemic, I would try to make a monthly visit to the chapel, to the center in on along C5, C.P. Garcia. And when you go there, you know, it's a place filled with so much prayer. Mararamdaman mo, no? Di ba nararanasan natin pag pumupunta tayo sa mga pilgrimage sites, pagpasok mo pa lang nung lugar, mararamdaman mo na yung atmosphere of prayer. Diba? Parang talagang may kakaibang karanasan when you go to a place of prayer. And I think that's true also for us, diba? Pag nagpupunta tayo sa mga Blessed Sacrament Chapel, and yun yung nami-miss natin ngayon, diba? Yung mga lugar na pwede natin puntahan, no? Pero sa tingin ko, ang mahalaga sa lahat ay yung pag-anyaya sa atin ngayon ng pagdadasal, no? The invitation to prayer. I think one of the great gifts or charisms or graces of Father Pio is precisely the invitation to prayer. I think many of us turn to him to ask for his intercession because we know that he is a prayerful man, no? That his prayers are all powerful, so to speak. And yet, I think the more important thing is that he invites us to prayer. Inaanyayahan niya tayong magdasal. In fact, di ba yung famous line niya is ano, pray, hope, and do not worry. Pray, hope, and do not worry. And I think on his feast day, you know, that is again something that we'd like to renew in us. Again, the gift of prayer and the prayer that leads us to hope and the prayer that leads us to not to be anxious. Siguro yun ang pwede natin hilingin ngayon sa kanya sa araw ng kanyang kapistahan, yung biyaya na magkaroon ulit ng isang buhay at malalim na prayer life at yung isang panalangin, isang buhay panalangin na magpapalakas ng ating pag-asa at pananalig sa Diyos. At kasama nitong malakas na pananalig at pananampalataya at pag-asa sa Diyos, ay malampasan natin ang ating mga bagay na gumugulo sa ating isipan, ng ating mga anxieties. Let us ask for that grace, na, to pray, to hope, and not to worry. The second point that I invite you to reflect on is just to also reflect on the ministries of Father Pio. He is known to be, number one, a confessor, very, 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 very popular confessor. And then number two is his devotion to the Mass. His stigmata would come out during times that he would celebrate the Mass. Imagine for 50 years, it first appeared, the stigmata first appeared in, I think, 1918, and he died in 1968. But all throughout those years, it comes out, and especially during moments that he would say the Mass. And in fact, there is a famous story that Graham Greene, the author, when he wanted to see the stigmata of Padre Pio, he visited him. So he was watching dun sa chapel, ano, nanunood siya. Tapos noon, habang nagmimisa si Padre Pio, biglangang dumugo, ano, yung mga stigmata. So si Graham Greene natakot, no? Natakot, umalis siya. Tapos bumalik siya sa kanyang hotel, no? Tapos nung hapon, nung kinahaponan, may isang Father Pio was a Capuchin monk, no? So may isang batang seminarista na nagpunta kay Graham Greene. At sabi sa kay Graham Greene ng waiter, meron ho naghahanap sa inyo. And he let the young seminarian come in. And sabi nung young seminarian kay Graham Greene, sabi sa kanya, may meron akong message from Father Pio. Ang pinasasabi lang ho niya ay huwag daw kayong matakot. So, you know, I think I always am inspired by that story, no? That Father Pio's devotion to the Mass, and because of that devotion to the Mass, remember, the stigmata is a sign of a deep union with Christ. In fact, union with the sufferings of Christ. And Graham Greene was taken aback, no, by the wounds, no, by the stigmata, and natakot siya, no? And that message of Father Pio, do not be afraid. And I guess it's a good reminder to us also, do not be afraid. Huwag tayong matakot sa dinadaanan nating mga pagsubok ngayon, itong krisis na dinadaanan natin. And most certainly, again, the devotion to the Mass, the devotion to the sacrament of reconciliation, all of these are healing sacraments that Father Pio really propagated in his lifetime. And I guess his message to Graham Greene, do not be afraid, is a message that continues to, I guess, to be proclaimed by these sacraments. Because the sacrament of the Mass will heal us. The sacrament of the Mass will keep us united with Christ. And for us to just deepen our devotion to the Mass, to prayer, and the Lord will take care of us. Do not be afraid. The third and final point I'd like to take from the Gospel. You know, the Gospel is very much attuned to the feast today, wherein the Lord tells His disciples, when you go out to proclaim the good news, when you go out to do God's work, do not be anxious. Huwag kayong masyadong mag-alala. Do not take too many things with you. Huwag tayong masyadong mabahala. Huwag tayong masyadong mag-alala. Of course, kailangan natin magplano. Kailangan natin ayusin ang ating mga gagawin. Pero sa katapusan, di ba? Pagka nagawa na natin lahat ng ating magagawa, magtiwala tayo sa Diyos. Sapagkat ang Diyos na tumatawag sa atin para simulan ang ating mga ginagawa, at alam natin na, alam ko na pinagdadasal natin, ito ba talaga ang gustong pagawa sa atin ng Diyos? Marami tayong mga nakakasama dito sa misa na nasa abroad, nagtatrabaho doon, at sumasama sila sa ating mga misa, pinagnilayan yan at talagang pinagdasalan na ito ba ang kagustuhan ng Diyos para makatulong ako sa pamilya ko. Na huwag tayong, bagaman magplano at kailangan talagang magplano ng mabuti, sa katapusan, magtiwala tayo sa Diyos. That in the midst of the many challenges, in the midst of the many uncertainties, yes, we need to plan, but when everything is said and done, when we can do everything that we can do, possibly do, the best way that we can do it, the final act is trust. The final ascent of faith is to believe that it is God who called us, it is God who will sustain us, and it is God who will bring what we are doing to completion. At yun ang panalangin natin ngayong araw na ito. Let us pray and ask for the prayers of Father Pio that we may develop the trust. As Father Pio would always say, pray, hope, do not worry. Because we have a God who is lovingly, providentially present in all moments of our life. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God the Father has invited us to be ministers to spread the good news of salvation to all. Let us ask God to make us credible witnesses. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may continue to call and send missionaries to preach the good news to all nations and places. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians may be committed in proclaiming God's word to unbelieving and unwelcoming places. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That many people may be attracted to the Christian faith through our credible witness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and those who find life burdensome may see God's special love and care through the concern of their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may enjoy everlasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And again, we ask you to please pray for ABS-CBN. Praying specially for its employees, its leaders, that they may continue the work and mission of ABS. And please also kindly remember in your prayers all the employees and their families, the employees who were retrenched. And we'd like to ask you to continue to offer with us this prayer to our Blessed Mother for ABS and its employees. Together we pray, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women. And blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, through goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of blessed priest Saint Pius, so that as you brought these sacred mysteries, grant to us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Pius you bid your Church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Padre Pio, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. through Him, with Him, and in Him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Together, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast day of Blessed Saint Padre Pio, that we may persevere in integrity, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.